So our next goal is to implement the perceptron algorithm in code. But before we can do so, we need to set up our computing environment. For that, there are mainly three things to consider. First, we need something where we can write our code. Next, we also need a way to install Python libraries, because the tools we are going to use in this course don't come with a standard Python library, since they are pretty advanced. And thirdly, we also need a way to run and to debug our code. So for writing your code, you can really use whatever you prefer. However, what I find most convenient and productive is using Visual Studio Code. Visual Studio Code is free and open source, and it's supported on Linux, Windows, and Mac. So while Visual Studio Code is one of the most popular text editors for writing code, in this course, we will actually make heavy use of something called JupyterLab. So JupyterLab is a notebook environment for Jupyter notebooks, and it's particularly attractive for interactive analyses and also teaching, where we want to explain one concept at a time. Now for installing Python libraries, personally I prefer the Conda Package Manager, which allows you to manage your Python version and also install additional Python libraries pretty easily. And personally, I also prefer to use Conda with the MiniForge repository, which is a well-tested and well-maintained repository of Python libraries. So if you use Conda for this course, I encourage you to create a new virtual environment. Once you activated your virtual environment, you can then install packages using the Conda Package Manager. However, note that you are not restricted to just using Conda. You can always also use pip, the traditional way of installing Python packages. Now, when it comes to running and debugging code, personally, I prefer using Visual Studio Code for most of my coding tasks. However, in this course, we will be also using JupyterLab quite a lot because it's a very convenient environment for interactive analyses and incremental workflows. So in this video, we saw a brief overview of a typical computing environment. We will provide you with additional resources to set it up on your computer. However, let's now dive in and let's implement our first machine learning algorithm.